With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
A right angled prism of refractive index mu1 is placed in a rectangular block of refractive index mu2, which is surrounded by a medium of refractive index mu3, as shown in the figure. A ray of light E enters the rectangular block at normal incidence, that is at angle 90 degree. Depending upon the relationship between mu1, mu2 and mu3, it takes one of the four possible paths, that is EF, EG, EH or EF. So in this question, we have to find the relation between mu1, mu2 and mu3 for each of these paths. So now let's start with the path EF first. Now first EF, that is path E and F. Now here the ray tends to bend towards the normal. At this point, this line, that is this path, tends to bend towards the normal. Hence I can say mu2 is greater than mu1, because when a light, this is the normal, this incident light, and if this light bends away from the normal, this means this is rarer medium and this is denser medium, and if this light ray bends towards the normal, this means it is denser medium and it is rarer medium. So it's bent towards the normal, so I can say for this path EF, mu2 is greater than mu1. Now look at this. If we draw normal at this point. Now at this point, this ray tends to bend away from the normal. Hence, this is rarer medium with respect to 2. So I can say mu2 is again greater than mu3. So for first path EF, mu2 is greater than mu1 and is also greater than mu3. Now we can't comment on mu1 and mu3. What is the relation between mu1 and mu3? Now path EG. Taking path EG. Now look at the path EG. This is a straight path. There is no any deviation in the path. So there is no any refraction. So there are two conditions of no any refraction. If the angle of incidence is 90 degree and if the surrounding mediums, that is medium 1 and medium 2, both have same refractive index. So this path is a straight path with no deviation. So I can say mu1 is equal to mu2 is equal to mu3. So for path EG, all three mediums are same, that is mu1 is equal to mu2 equal to mu3. Now coming to EH. Now this EH, this is the path EH. Now after refraction, the light tends to bend away from the normal. So mu1 is greater than mu2. Mu2 will be rarer medium with respect to mu1. So I can say for path EH, mu1 is greater than mu2. Now again here, draw a normal. Now as you can see, the refracted light tends to bend away from the normal. This is a normal, so it bends away from the normal. Hence again, mu3 is a rarer medium with respect to mu2. So I can say mu2 is greater than mu3. Mu2 is greater than mu3. Hence for path EH, we can say mu1 is greater than mu2 is greater than mu3. Now last, path EI. Now here, this is TIR, total internal reflection. So first we have to find the IC, that is critical angle. Now this is critical angle IC, this is 90 degree, this is mu1 and this is mu2. Now for this I can write mu1 sin I c IC is equal to mu 2 sine 90 degree. So I can write sine IC is equal to mu 2 upon mu 1, that is sine 90 is 1. So I can say critical angle is sine inverse mu 2 upon mu 1. Now if this angle is 45 degree, this angle will also be 45 degree because this is 90. So this angle is 45 degree, so this angle is also 45 degree. So in this case, angle of incidence, that is for EI case, for path EI, angle of incidence is 45 degree. Now critical angle, I have already calculated sine inverse mu 2 upon mu 1. Now for TIR to happen, angle I, that is angle of incidence, must be greater than critical angle. So now put the value of IC here. I is greater than sine inverse mu 2 upon mu 1. Now angle of incidence is 45 degree, so put it here, 45 degree sine inverse mu 2 upon mu 1. Take the sine inverse here, so I can write sine 45 greater than mu 2 by mu 1. Now value of sine 45 is 1 upon root 2 greater than mu 2 upon mu 1. Hence I can say for this path mu 1 is greater than root 2 times mu 2. So this is the final result. Now for this path, that is EI path, EI, we can't comment on mu 3 because the angle of incidence here and also here is 90 degree. So I can't comment on mu 3. I can only find a relation between mu 1 and mu 2 for this path.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.